I'm delighted to join you today in spirit, if not actually in person. And many of you will have heard me speak before, and you will know the pride and love that we as a family have for ICPP. Here we are 56 years later, and it is an honor and a privilege to be with you today. Everyone here today, i.e. everybody online, and I mean everybody, from the director, the academics, the administrative staff, and the students, each and every one of you is here because of the spirit of Salam. Some choose to remember my father as a man of science and a great physicist. Some choose to remember him as a Muslim world and first Nobel laureate for the sciences. But I strongly believe and suggest he should be remembered, above all else, for his humanitarian work, and his passion and his love for the service of humanity. As you know, Abu Salam means servant of peace, and he certainly lived up to that name. And some of you were here in 1997, and ICTP became the Abu Salam ICTP. And we held a wonderfully moving celebration of the life and times of our father. One of the speakers was a very talented science writer, Nigel Calder, who has known my father since the early 1960s. Nigel had been introduced to physics by my father back then. We got to know him very well. Nigel went on to edit The New Scientist, as well as author a large number of books throughout the 60s and 70s and through into the 80s. And he was a pioneer in explaining science in the most simple way to the man on the street. Nigel was one of those most respected speakers who came to Trieste in 1997. And in his address, he spoke about the Salam's cosmic anger. Now, we as a family knew that father had a very quick temper. He did get angry quick, but then forgot it very quickly too. So when Nigel mentioned his anger, we were not sure where he was going with this. So we were a little uncomfortable, but Nigel went on to simply say that Abu Salam had a deep anger at the divide between the developed and the developing world, the arrogance of the developed world imposing their will on the developing world. An anger at the inequality of the world simply because of an accident of birth. And yet Father combined this cosmic anger actually with a great cosmic patience to work tirelessly to try and bridge and reduce the gap between the developed and developing world, at least in science and technology. And if you remember that Father was just 34 years old when he began this work in earnest. And it is the service of humanity, which is the essence behind the creation of ICTP. Father had a huge struggle to overcome the resistance and arrogance of the developed countries who opposed the creation of ICTP. Father persevered to keep going where many would simply have given up. And until he could not work any longer, until his physical strength had gone, yet his mind was still as fresh as ever. He was cruelly forced to stop working for his true love and passion, the ICTP, and all it stood for, and all it represented. His priority in life was the ICTP and everything that it embodied. And throughout his time, as in Trieste, he had one rule. His day was divided into three, one part for administration, one part for his science, and the most important part, to keep the door open for all the students and colleagues. And he would literally keep an open door policy for students and colleagues to come and see him and talk to him about their work, their issues, their problems, whether personal or work related. And he would be there in any way that he could to support, nurture, and encourage them. His father took great interest and great pride and great responsibility for every single person who walked through the doors of ICTP, in whatever capacity or role they were there. And interestingly, not just these people are the ones who came through the door did he get to know, but he also got to know their families very well. And this was no mean feat to keep all these competing, time-consuming challenges going. And of course, ICTP was smaller then, but somehow, with a superhuman effort and the support of some amazingly committed people, Father managed to keep all these three priorities intact, but obviously at a considerable cost to himself, his health, and his family life. But that was a price he was willing to pay for such a noble cause. is so special to him and so important that for Father it's a price worth paying. So my plea to everyone here today, all the wonderful people who are a part of ICTP and the wonderful family of ICTP, don't just look at your time as ICTP as a job, a routine, but look at it, all these illustrious people around who preceded you and are with you now. And remember that you too can play a huge role in continuing the work started by Ahmad Salam. Look at the legacy and look at the role model of this great humble man. And if, let me just finish on this part before I actually talk about the Spirit of Salam Award. As you know, one of my father's favorite poems is by John Donne. No man is an island of itself. Every man is a piece of the continent, part of the main. God be washed away by the sea, Europe is the less. As if it were a promontory were, as well as any man of thy friends or of thine own were. Any man's death diminishes me, for I am involved in mankind. And therefore never send to know for whom the bell tolls, it tolls for thee. So the Spirit of Salam Award was established to remember and remind everyone at ICTP, as I said, the real reason for the existence of ICTP. It came about because of one man's vision and sacrifice, and it came about because one man was determined and committed to try to make their change and devote his life to try and help his fellow human beings. And I'm absolutely delighted this year to award the Spirit of Salam Award to three recipients. First is Muhammad Hassan. Muhammad Hassan is a distinguished and highly influential Sudanese advocate for science in the developing world. He was an early career Sudanese mathematician when Ahmad Salam recruited him to come to ICTP. In 1983, Salam asked him to help organize the foundation meeting that would establish the Third World Academy of Sciences, the World Academy of Sciences as it's now known. And at the recommendation of Salam, the first founding fellows appointed Hassan as the first executive director in 1985. He remained in that role for 26 years, becoming a close advisor to Salam and developing Trust's worldwide networks that have had a far-reaching impact. Hassan has been a long friend and collaborator of Father. Father picked him as a man with a charm, intellect, and flair to drive Trust as it was then, from just an idea to reality. I always believe Father knew that in Hassan he would have someone who could learn the art of networking, building bridges, and developing communities. Hassan delivered what Father needed and helped build into the fine organization it is today. He has worked tirelessly in the Spirit of Salam to further education, science, and technology for all. He has led from the front and always been willing to sacrifice himself and his comfort for a much more noble cause. I know my father was very fond of Hassan. I saw them on many occasions interacting together. I was very grateful to him for the hard work and effort he put into building a strong foundation for us. We are honored to award Hassan the Spirit of Salam. Second recipient is Gregorio Medrano Asensio from Spain. Gregorio is a Spanish physicist and has a long history of collaboration with my father and was a frequent visitor to ICTP. Inspired by Ahmad Salam, in 1980, Asensio proposed the creation in Spain of a Center for Energy Studies. This would have established a triangular forum between Spain, the Islamic heritage Spain had, the Islamic world, and Latin America. Unfortunately, the project did not materialize due to some political changes in Spain. But Gregorio is another long-term associate and friend of Ahmad Salam. He lived and breathed the Spirit of Salam, and he believed that the need to build bridges and build for a greater good. Whilst Gregorio was heavily influenced and inspired by Father, he also followed his own path, but he always kept the ethos and words of Father in sight. If the Center for Energy Studies had become reality, it would have allowed a part of the Islamic world to gain a seat at the top table of intellectual excellence and would have given Latin America a much needed boost and step up to also develop relevant expertise and excellence. It is our collective loss that the Center did not materialize this time around, but we must be optimistic and believe that Gregorio's and Father's dream may still become a reality. We are delighted to award Gregorio the Spirit of Salam Award. Hilda Sedera from Argentina. Hilda was a scientist in ICTP condensed matter section until her retirement in 2004. In addition to her scientific work, she developed ICTP's e-journals delivery service, a tool which allows scientists at institutions in the least developed or low-income countries to access current scientific literature, mainly in the fields of physics and mathematics. The articles are sent as an email so as to reach individual scientists who do not have access to sufficient bandwidth to download material from the internet in a timely manner and or cannot afford the connection. It's a matter of great pleasure for us to choose Hilda, as her contribution was so in the whole spirit of ICTP and FARBA, with everything that they stood for, that no person should be denied access to intellectual stimulation, support, and knowledge, and the accident of birth would not hinder their personal development. Hilda has worked tirelessly and without wanting any recognition for her work. She's worked quietly and passionately to make the delivery service a reality and ensure access for all. The platform that Hilda helped to create could well be scaled up beyond just mathematics and physics, and it would be wonderful to see this happen. In many ways, Hilda embodies the Spirit of Salam, and we are thrilled to award Hilda the Spirit of Salam Award. My deep thanks and appreciation to Atish and all the organizers of today's event, and I do hope we meet again in person soon. And as a family, our best wishes for you all. Thank you on behalf of the whole Salam family. May God bless you all and keep you safe. Thank you.